The Remembering the Past, Building the Future project aims to highlight the importance of remembrance. We are going to initiate a new process of investigated national and European history in a broader perspective by using art and intercultural dialogue as a means to learn about the past and connect it to the present situation. It gives me a great pleasure to extend to you all a very warm welcome on behalf of Jugend- und Kulturprojekt e.V. to the conference of the 18-month project Remembering the Past, Building the Future within the framework of the Europe for Citizens program.
Regarding the wars and the millions of refugees in the last few years, we wonder if history teaches us and if art can change our lives.
On 8 March 1933, the Art Academy in Dresden was the first art academy in Germany to hoist a flag with the swastika.
Book burnings were organized, artists and musicians were dismissed from teaching positions, and curators who had shown a positive attitude towards modern art were replaced by party members.
Music and politics were used in different political, ideological and social contexts to strengthen ideologies and policies and also to support practices in Nazi Germany.
Artists, of course, writers and other intellectuals had the energy to believe that they can change the way of thinking of people.
How can one approach and showcase in the public space memories of trauma? Trauma being that which can absolutely not be represented. The first example is a worldwide famous building of what we usually call commemorative architecture, the Jewish Museum in Berlin.
Art is the evidence of our existence. We use it in order to interpret the life of a man or of a human society.
Trying to understand the past of the continent, I mean Europe, will help us to avoid errors we committed in the past and plan a safer future far from any kind of fanatics of politics or religion.
I'm very pleased to be here, and I would like to thank a lot the organization of Qatar Art and Technology Lab, all the people who contributed.
Στις 15 Μαρτίου 1943, εδώ στον παλιό σιδηροδρομικό σταθμό της πόλης, σφυρίζει το πρώτο τρένο του θανάτου για το Auschwitz-Birkenau.
In Holocaust Remembrance Day, across the globe, the enlightened world promised year after year, never again. But promises are not enough. The evil that killed 6 million Jews and many others at the Nazi camps is still here and is a threat to the world peace. And the only thing that can guarantee that Auschwitz will never return is a continuing battle against fascism, racism, and hate of people different than us.
Για να είμαι τουλάχιστον σωστή στα σχέδια και στα όνειρά μου, ανάμεσα σε λυγμούς και σε παροξισμούς, κρατώ τη γλώσσα.
Και θα ξεσπάσω. Και δεν θα φοβηθώ. Και θα ελπίζω.
Και κάθε στιγμή το λαρίκι μου θα γεμίζει με ένα φθόγκο.
Με ένα ψήθυρο.
Με ένα τράβλισμα.
Με μια κραυγή που θα μου λέει
«Μίλα!».
Nur so kurz gelebt und wenig für mein Land getan zu haben. Onkel, jetzt habe ich mich ans Gefängnis gewöhnt. Ich bin nicht allein. Wir sind viele. Onkel, deswegen habe ich keine Angst für den Tod. Sag Mutter, sie soll nicht sein.
Thank you.
I think this covers the Thessaloniki in a way, because it's like a cloud which transforms itself through the 2000-year presence of a city.